Norway in the snow. Apples. Imagine if I actually knew what the fuck I was doing. Fog and snow are kind of the same on this, because, like, does snow affect the handling of the car? Does it make it rain slippery? Otherwise it's kind of just fog, isn't it? Maybe it does make it more slippery. I don't know. I can't remember how this felt in the dry. Like an absolute slip and slide anyway. I hope that the volume levels are okay. I do actually have to upload all the videos I've got. I've got like shitloads that I haven't uploaded. The hardest part is figuring out what the fucking number is. So after this one, I'll be halfway through the Dakar. Ah, piss, I forgot that corner. Oh fuck. I wonder how that's gonna feel. It's gonna be a really weird D-pad, like, I suppose it's back to the Xbox 360 D-pad. Just thinking about that, I've ordered a new controller for console gaming. Xbox custom one. Xbox Series custom controller. Because I like the Xbox One controller. That's what I'm using at the minute. It's broken, as you can see from the fucking up and down of the thumbstick. It's buggered. So yeah, I've ordered a new one. Having spoken to a few people, it came down to get the official one, because it's pretty good. Get a custom one, because they look cool, you can do gay pattern. And, yeah. Yeah, they've gone back to the 360 D-pad, kind of big solid dish plate thing. I'm just thinking, what the hell that's going to feel for the twice I ever use that thing. See, I don't really use the D-pad for anything. Actually, no, I do. That's a lie. I do. So for one, I use it to reset, but that's not really... not an issue, because I like never drive off the track, you know? What are you talking about? But I do use it for menuing, because it's a bit cleaner than thumbstick, I find. But I never used the one on the Xbox, because it was weird. But I suppose if they've kept it as an actual like four-way D-pad, rather than being the fucking weird version that the 360 had, if it's just a dish plate, which I will admit looks cool, I like it. Yeah, because the D-pad on this ain't bad. This is unofficial, but you know, same style, same everything. Well, it's officially licensed, but it's licensed, isn't it? You know. It's a nice controller, it's a shame it fucking broke with this thumbstick bollocks. But hopefully the other one is better and has better thumbsticks, because that is the one big ass thing that I hate about this controller, is the thumbsticks are very plasticky and hard. And while yes, they'll never wear out, annoyingly you can't change them. I'd rather they did wear out, because I like things that wear out. I like witnessing the passage of time and things that shouldn't... things that are considered, you know, infinite, wearing out slowly. Through use, you know. Like handles for things that are replaceable. like the wear of a knife. The actual knife blade, yeah, that'll wear out, that'll, you know, you'll do whatever, but the actual plastic or metal housing it's in, and the handle, that wearing out, so cool. The big long one. Eat the big long one. Wait, did I double up? I thought that the ramp was at the end of the forwards. Huh. Must be wrong, because I thought you went ramp really quickly. Because like you'll just finish within a minute of that, and then within a minute of the next one. Oh well. I can't see shit. Oh fuck. Hey. We're in. Oh, piss and balls. Overcooked it. Just a touch overcooked. Now, bald cock tits.
So, how are we doing today, chat?
Hope any grinding you've been doing has gone well. Oh, piss and balls. You'd think I might get good at this game by the end of this challenge, you know, having driven the tracks. Every single one of them. Freaking shitloads of times, and every car hundreds of times. Like nearly 200 tracks per car, about 1,500 kilometres or so it's going to be per car. Or at least per group, because there might be a couple of groups that I don't really know my favourite car in yet. I'm probably just going to go meta cars. Like, I'm going to the Esky.
Group 2.
Rotary Group 3. Brick ain't meta, but I like it. Group 4. Probably Hyena Group B. Rotary B7. Group S. The Kingpin Group A. Group A is pretty condensed, apparently, though. Like, it doesn't really matter what you run, but it's my favourite rally car, is the Kingpin. And it looks a lot more, I don't know, something about the way that it's ended up in this game. Compared to, like, the Subaru, which I also really like. I think it's because it's the wrong Subaru. Like, it either needs to be the slightly newer, shinier WRC, or the actual Group A. Like, older model Impreza, Richard Burns level. Whoop. Slide. That's not a bad turret shred. Wow. Balls. Whee! I'm not going to be able to do that jump in most other classes. Group 2's just going to fling me in anything faster than Group 2's probably going to... absolutely send it. Balls. And the last one in Norway. Third. That is surprisingly good. How many people played that track? Three. Oh no, decent amount. Decent amount. Alright. Nice.